now that we've mastered counting lists in which the numbers go up by one each time, we should ask ourselves, what about lists that go up by something other than one? For example, check out this list. We go up by 4 each time. We start at 24, we go to 28, 32, and say we keep going all the way up to 92. How do we count the numbers in this list? Well, before what we did was we turned the first number into 1, hoping to turn a list into 1, 2, 3. So let's try that here. We did that usually by subtracting or adding to the first number to turn that into 1. Here we subtract 23 from 24, we get 1. And the next number, oh, we'll do that, 28 minus 23, that gives us 5. And we subtract 23 from 32, we get 9. That's a problem. Where are 2, 3, and 4, and 6, 7, and 8? This 1, 5, now this is a list we don't know what to, do with this list. Let's step back and think about this again. And look at our original list here. Well, 24 is 4 times 6, and 28 is 4 times 7, and 32 is 4 times 8. Aha! 4 times 6, 4 times 7, 4 times 8, 6, 7, 8. That's a list that goes up by 1 each time. We know how to count that. So, let's divide each of these numbers by 4. And look what we're doing here. By dividing by 4, we're making our gaps that were 4, we're turning them into gaps of just 1. And now our list is 6, 7, 8, and that goes on up to 92 divided by 4 is 23. And this is a list we know how to deal with. We can subtract 5 from each number in this list, and that'll give us our 1, 2, 3, and on up to 23 minus 5 is 18. And nothing we did here changed the number of numbers that are in the list. There are 18 numbers in this list, so there are 18 numbers in this list. And that means there are 18 numbers in this list. So now we know how to count by fours. Now let's try another example just to make sure we have this down. This time we're going to count by threes. And you know, while I like to be a positive, upbeat kind of guy, sometimes I have to go negative. And that's what we're going to do here. We're going to go negative. We're going to start off with negative 23. And we're going to go up by 3 each time. So the first step will take us up to negative 20. The next one up to negative 17. And so we just keep on going. And we stop at 121. All right, now we could just list them all out. List them all out and count them off, 1, 2, 3. But first of all, that doesn't look like much fun. It'll take a long time and we might make some mistakes. So maybe we can find something smarter to do. Now, before when we were taking steps of 4, we divided by 4 to make them steps of 1. Here we have steps of 3, so we try dividing by 3 to make those steps of 1. And when we divide 23 by 3, we get a O. We get a fraction. Now, maybe we can deal with that, but let's be honest, who likes fractions? Nobody likes fractions. So before we start dealing with all these yucky fractions, let's step back and think about it again. And see if there's a way we can avoid fractions, because we like avoiding fractions, that's good. So when we were taking steps of 4, all the numbers were multiples of 4. So when we divided by 4, everything came out nice and even, we were able to deal with it. So here, our first step, well, maybe we just turn them all into multiples of 3. These are all one more than a multiple of 3. This is one more than negative 24, this is one more than negative 21, this is one more than 120, so we subtract 1 from each number in this list. And again, this doesn't change the number of numbers in the list. So this is perfectly okay. And we have a new list. Negative 24, negative 21. And again, going down by 3 on each step. But now all our numbers are multiples of 3. That's interesting. So since this list, we're taking steps of 3. They're all multiples of 3. We think we know how to deal with that. We'll divide them all by 3 so that our steps will just be steps of 1. And let's see what that does to our list. We get negative 8, then negative 7, then negative 6, and so on up to 40. And this is a list we know how to deal with. This is a list where we're just going up by 1 each time. We can add 9 to everything in this list, and we get the old 1, 2, 3 back. 1, 2, 3, all the way up to, at the end here, 40 plus 9. That's 49. There are 49 numbers in this list, so there are 49 numbers in this list, 49 numbers in this list, and 49 numbers in our original list. And notice we didn't even have to deal with fractions. But unfortunately, sometimes we have to. And I'm going to make you deal with fractions right now. So imagine we start with 9 and 7 eighths. No getting around this fraction. We're going to start with 9 and 7 eighths. And instead of changing by a whole number each time, you guessed it, we're going to change by a fractional part. Not only that, we're going to go down instead of going up. So this seems like a completely different kind of problem. Or is it? So notice we're just going down by 3/8 each time. And we'll just keep on going, and we'll end it. Let's see, our last two numbers will be 1 1/4 and 7/8. Those will be our last two numbers. And the question again is, how many numbers are in this list? Well, the first thing we think after thinking, fractions, nobody likes fractions. We think, well, how do we get rid of the fractions? And we see that all these denominators are 2, 4, and 8. So if we just multiply everything by 8, if we just multiply each number by 8, all the fractions will go away. And that makes us happy because we don't like fractions. So we multiply all these numbers by 8. And our first one here, 9 times 8 is 72, and we get 7 more when we multiply 8 by 7/8. So that gives us 79. And then the next one, 8 times 9, that's 72. 8 times 1/2, that's 4 more. That gives us 76. And the next one, 8 times 9, 72. 8 times 1/8 gives us 1 more. That's 73. And we notice our list is going down by 3 each time. And that makes sense, right? We were going down by 3/8 each time in this list. So when we multiply everything by 8, now our new list will go down by 3/8 times 8, which is just 3. And if we keep going, we have this list. And this list looks a lot like lists we know how to deal with. All right, each step is, in this case, it's negative 3. We're going down 3. But, you know, this going down isn't really so much a problem, right? We can think backwards and look at it as going from the end to the beginning, 7, 10, 13, on up to 79. So we're still just taking steps of 3 and forming a list. And we know how to deal with that. Now, we might divide by 3 to make those steps back to 1, but of course, dividing this by 3, that gives us a bunch of fractions. And what's the point of getting rid of these fractions if we're just going to bring back more fractions? But we know how to avoid the fractions. We turn these into multiples of 3. And we can do that by subtracting 1. Look, I'm thinking ahead here. I'm already starting from the end because I know I'm going to count from the end. And I subtract 1 from each number in this list, and we get a new list. We have 6, 9, and we have 69, 72, 75, 78. And we know how to deal with this list. These are all just multiples of 3. We can divide them all. Just divide them all by 3. And we have our new list. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. On up to 23, 24. And now you see where we're going. 25, 26. And this is a list we know how to deal with. We're going up by 1s from 2 to 26. We're down by 1s from 26 down to 2. This is just the list of numbers from 1 to 26, except for the one at the beginning. So there are 25 numbers in this list. And nothing we did here changed the numbers in the lists. So this has 25 numbers, this has 25 numbers, this has 25 numbers. And now we know how to count by numbers besides 1. We know how to count by whole numbers, we know how to count by fractions, we know how to count up, we know how to count down. So now we've mastered counting numbers in lists.